we need to talk about it. We need to share our ideas also about the music industry, the gospel and the secular music. We want to talk about it today. So join us today, and as usual, like our page and subscribe for us so that you get more alert. It's better you click on the bell so that any message that we post, any video that we post, you get alert. If you click on that bell, the bell is there. You see, on top of the subscriber, you will see there is a bell there. If you click on that one, it will come personalized and all. If you click on that all, so any message that comes, any video that we post in our YouTube channel, you will get the first alert. Thank you for doing that. God bless you. Okay, here we go. My name is Willy, and
I am Salom.
Okay, as you can see today, I'm having my headset because we want to talk about the music industry. And if you want to talk about the music industry, you have to be listening to some songs. That if you want to talk about, you have to know what is going on in the music industry. So, God bless you today, my brother.
Yes.
Okay, you are welcome once again to this platform. Today, our topic is the music industry, and we want to go into details.
Okay.
Now, most of the countries, most of the continent, they are saying the gospel musicians and the secular musicians, now they are the same, they can't see any difference. So I just want to ask you today that, is it good for a gospel musician be featured in secular music, or a gospel musician feature a secular musician in their songs?
Okay, thank you very much, and thank you all our listeners who is part of this Wise Multimedia platform. I extend my greetings to you once again. As we are talking today about the music industry, you know, music is something that makes everybody happy, you know.
Okay.
And then music can also change the human nature, you understand? So me, I always say that music is life.
Music is life.
Because let's say, for instance, you are moody, you have a bad day, for instance, and you put some gospel music in, and the music will change your system. Once you start listening to the music, your idea, your thoughts about what you have been thinking about the whole day may change. Let's say, for instance, you put in reggae music. You start, after some time, you see your body start jumping, you know, reggae, jazz, rastafari, and all that. Yeah, so let's go straight to the point. As we are talking about secular music and gospel music, a lot of complaints are on the internet that, you know, they cannot really see the difference between secular music and the gospel in the industry. As we know, gospel is, let's say, a music that is, let's say, brings holiness and teaches about religious things. But secular music, you know, is out to the people who like to go to the pub, to go to the club, you know, and all that. But now, we find out that secular musicians sometimes are featuring some gospel musicians. Sometimes even pastors are inviting secular musicians to the church. Yeah, for me, what I would say about a pastor inviting a secular musician to the church.
Okay, my first question was, is it good for a secular musician to be featured in gospel?
Yeah, I'm coming to that. Yeah, is it good for secular musician,
yeah, to be featured in the gospel,
to be featured by a gospel musician, yeah, to be featured by a gospel musician. With that one, let me say that, you know, when we go in a religious way, our religious book tells us that light and darkness cannot move together. And most of the time, these secular musicians that don't lead us through to holiness. It doesn't lead us to, let's say, religious life. Because sometimes in some of these musics, they end up showing up some parts of the body that we are not supposed to be seeing on the internet. And even our children, they used to see these things, and they hear a lot of things that they say, and, you know, it's spoiling our generations that are coming up. So to me, it's a big question mark for a secular musician to be featured by a gospel musician. Okay, sometimes it can also happen in the sense that if a gospel musician is featuring a secular musician, as I said before, if you are light, you can somehow befriend darkness so that you can change the darkness to light. You understand? So if the gospel musician is featuring the secular musician, in one way or the other, it may reach a point, the gospel musician says, okay, let's do this gospel music. Let's do this, that. Let's do this and that. So as time goes on, you see, this secular musician may have a thought that, oh, even after doing that music, I feel something within me. I feel like only secular music in me. You understand? So, you know, yeah, so it can be like that one way or the other one can change. You know, there are a lot of musicians on this planet that I've seen. They were before secular musicians. Then at a point of time, they totally changed, they have totally converted, now they are gospel musicians. Do you understand? So anything can happen. Yeah.
Okay, if I can recall, if I'm right, there was one, what do you call it? The secular musician called Wendy Shea from Ghana. Wendy Shea from Ghana.
Yeah.
She featured one gospel artist in her song. And the song goes like, Yekoti Asore. Yekoti Asore. We are going to build a church. You see? Now, for Wendy Shea, because she is a secular musician, she played her part as a secular musician, and the gospel musician also played his part
as a gospel musician.
So what are they trying to tell the people?
Okay, you know, music, as I said, music is life. Music is also business. Do you understand? It doesn't mean that secular musicians are not Christians. It doesn't mean that secular musicians are not Muslims. It doesn't mean that secular musicians are not Buddhists. They are not Sikh. Sick is also a religion, yeah. It's not human sickness.
Okay.
Yeah. So gospel musicians, they all belong to a religion. It's like doing a business. Okay. You're a businessman, but you do let's say Bitcoin trading, you do this kind of you know, transportation of cars up and down, but you belong to one religion or the other, you understand? So it doesn't mean that these secular musicians are not religious, they are not in any religious denomination. They are. But now, that is business.
But they have devoted themselves to singing those
secular
kind of
music. Yeah, that is what I'm saying. It's business. It's business. See,
okay.
Let me tell you. There was one army officer. Let's say, if you look at an army officer, you think army officer is somehow people categorize them as they are, let me say, they have a bit of wickedness. You understand? But some of them are even religious leaders. There was one chief. Whole chief. You know, chiefs, when they lay you as a chief, a king, they slaughter what chief and they wear you some kind of staff, they make some rituals for you. This king stood in public one day and he just passed in tears with worship. And everybody was saying, wow. Everybody was amazed. So do you understand? These people, even before they stood him, perhaps he was a religious leader. So that thing is inside him. Physically, they put him there as a king, but you know, inside him, there is something that is.
This thing, as I'm saying, it means this gospel artist and secular artist is a talent, it's not a gift.
Yeah, actually. Yeah, it can be a talent. Yeah, it's not a gift. That is one which you.
So the gospel artist also is a talent that they have. It's and they chose to minister in the house of God.
In the house of God.
It's not a gift.
Exactly. You are probably to a point. Most, as well as gospel musicians or religious musicians, do you understand? Some of them, even they don't believe in what they are saying. They are doing it for business wise. Someone can come and say, oh, God is good, God is that, you know. Allah is good, Allah is that, you know. But they themselves, they don't believe in what they are saying. They are singing it to make money. Because they know I will put this and this thing. Because we have something called trending. There are seasons that when people will see that everybody wants to be religious. Everybody wants to be, so they will say religious things for you to make their money.
My bro, as per your statement, it means I can be a Christian at the same time going to club.
Of course, people do that. As I'm saying, people go to club, people own clubs, actually. And they go to church. They go to the mosque. See, excuse me to say this, but as we say, okay, Christians, it's not good. Also, we say it's not good to drink, you know. But in general, in Christendom, most people, you know, they take it for granted. In the Islamic religion as well, it's real. Some of them, they drink. And they'll tell you that, you know, when I die, I will face my judgment alone. You understand?
Okay, so do we have musicians who are gifted?
Or we have musicians that are gifted.
And if you are gifted, it means it's God who, you know, there's a difference between talent and gift.
And gifts.
Because talent is something that you were born with. And gift is you came and God gave it to you on earth. So before God gives you something, He gives you, what I know is He gives that gift so that you can minister to the people in His house. Now, me, let's say I'm a gospel artist and God has given me that gift to minister in His kingdom. But along the way, I will go and be with the secular musicians and start doing music with them. For them, they will feature me, they will try to change my life, you know, to be like them. Because when you are singing with them, there are certain things you will know about that. Why is it that these gospel musicians can't be in their lane and they are trying to jeopardize the gospel industry?
You know, there was one thing I could recall that, let me say maybe in the 80s, in the 70s, when there is a gospel musician, there is a way they play gospel drums, there is a way they play gospel beats, and there is a way they play gospel songs, you understand? But today, we have gospel songs that are rhyming like secular music, with the beat, everything. They are using the beat of the secular music, and they just put in the ways of religious. You understand? So this thing. See, let me. I'm not attacking anybody, but let me just use one popular pastor in Ghana as an example. This pastor is called the angel of Ghana, Prophet Obini. You know, this prophet. Bible said we shouldn't judge, but seriously, last time he did one miracle that. Now it has turned to challenge. Everybody is doing some of that same miracle.
Yeah, it's like now, Ghana, we don't have an embassy. If you want a big embassy, you go to Obini.
Yeah, if you want a passport, you.
Yeah.
You know, instant passport, no birth certificate, no details, nothing. Direct, your passport disappeared from the shoe. This is wonderful. And the one which happened in South Africa, this pastor, he was raising a dead person, and you know, a whole lot of things. People were feeding other church members with a gin, with so many other things. This one you cannot say that is a gift of God, you know. Uh-huh. So, a lot of people, let me finish my point. As you said, this thing of the music, we have something called deviation. So, someone can be a gospel musician. As I was using the prophet Obinim as an example, you know, maybe he has deviated, but he hasn't known. Maybe he has deviated. So these gospel musicians can also deviate. When they realize that they are singing a thing of religious, and the money is not coming, and they realize that people are singing those secular music and money is coming, they are buying the Bentleys, they are buying the Lamborghinis, and they are building mansions and all that. It is money, you know, they will divert. So they have deviated somehow, but they are trying to adjust themselves, like they are so in the religious life that they are deviating gradually, and before you know, they are out of play.
Okay. You know, I'm taking questions from your speech. You said some of the gospel, you know, music sounds like secular music. So it doesn't seem to be like a gospel song. if they are making that song or if they are playing that song, can you use that song to meditate and the Spirit of God comes down or not?
Yeah, that is a problem. You know, we have something we call worship. We have worship, and then we have praises. We have melody. You understand? So worship, you cannot put secular beats into worship. You understand? How will a meditation go? For me, what I know is that worship mass itself is not like, you know, praises is like, praises okay, praises people can put this kind of secular beats inside to make you dance, you know, to the beat, dance to the beat, you know. But in worship, you are not dancing, you are meditating. You are meditating. So with the secular beats, I don't think it's possible. It can go with meditation.
It cannot go with meditation.
With meditation, with the secular beats, when it comes to worship. But when it comes to praises, secular beats, you can put it there.
Okay. In the same scenario, can a secular artist sing a worship song for the Spirit of God to come down?
That's what I already said before, that there are secular artists. It doesn't mean that these secular artists are not religious. They don't belong to any religious
denomination. Yeah,
they belong to.
Yeah.
But now they are doing, as I said, also that deviation. Okay, they can be called by God, but because business is not moving, they deviate. It doesn't mean that the Holy Spirit is not with them. It doesn't mean that they don't call on their God and their God responds to them. You understand?
You know, initially you said. Sorry, my dearest. You said that the light and the darkness does not meet. So if you are doing a secular music, it means, sorry to say, I'm not saying you are in the darkness, but you have deviated.
That's the deviation of the
Spirit. Yeah, so being deviated means the Spirit of God is not in you any longer. So how can you sing a worship song
to
move God?
So now what I'm saying is, I'm not saying that the secular musician can sing a worship song to move, you know, but it also happened that, you know, the Bible says that Jesus said he did not come because of the clean people, okay? He came because of the ungodly, so that they can see the light. You might never know, you know, there are people who were, before in the Bible, they were prostitutes and all that, but God used them. Do you understand? There were people who did bad things, but still God used them. So we can't say that the person is a secular musician, so God cannot use them. Do you understand? God can use anybody, especially those who have deviated, especially those who have not known the light. Do you understand? God can use them to minister. Recently, if you can look at, there are some little young ladies. This is the, what's the name of this lady?
Odisheba
Priscilla. Can you imagine the kind of, the way God is just using this lady mightily to minister to people? It's not, that one is not, it's not book knowledge. When she starts to sing, she's not singing from her mind. The Holy Spirit is ministering through her. Do you understand? So, these secular musicians, it's the same thing. The body that you have belongs to God. The Bible says the body is the temple and the Holy Spirit dwells in the temple. If God decides to dwell in, you understand, you can't refuse.
So it means on that particular point, when they go in the house of God to minister, now they are holy. So that the Spirit can manifest through them.
It's not because they've gone to the house of God. Holiness doesn't come when you go to the house of God. It comes from you, the person. Do you understand?
Why is it?
It doesn't mean that you go to the house of God before you become holy.
Okay.
Holiness is something that you follow the principles and the precepts of let's say, our religious founders. Do you understand? So you can become holy.
Okay, I know back home when I was in Ghana, I used to go to some of the churches. There was a lady to sing. The Holy Spirit sing. But I know this lady is not holy. So most of the times I get confused that why is it that this lady is doing all sorts of things when she comes in the house of God, now all of a sudden everything changes.
Okay, now you said he goes to the boyfriend's place. Number one, we have boyfriend and we have boy lover. So you have the same boyfriend.
Okay, they are not doing the right thing. They are doing things that is against God, against the Bible.
But now, even if he goes to the boyfriend's place, so if I understand you well, the boy lover. So if he goes to the boy lover's place, perhaps they does nothing. Perhaps they are dating, you will never know. And you can date, and you may not go astray. So we can't condemn them. You understand?
Okay,
perhaps even he goes there, maybe they meditate on the word of God, you never know.
Okay, the thing is for me. I knew what was going on.
You knew?
Yeah, what was going on in both of them. You understand?
So
yeah,
if you know, then I think if you knew what was going on, then, sometimes, let me say this, sometimes the enemy tries to steal you from the kingdom. And the Bible says that the enemy comes to steal, to kill, and destroy. So, you can try to preserve yourself, but at the point of time, you find yourself that you are going astray and you don't know, it becomes difficult for you to come back. So, when it comes to the point that sometimes you have the conviction yourself that, I think I'm going astray, you redirect your path. Sometimes the ministration of the Holy Ghost will catch you to stop doing what you are doing. Sometimes a prophet will be sent to you to tell you that make your ways straight. You understand? So if he goes to the boyfriend's place, that is I cannot say it's because me, I don't know what he goes there to do. As you said, you know. So if you know and the person comes to church and minister and the Holy Spirit ministers, then it means God is still with him.
Okay. Let me ask you another question. Should we do the gospel for God or for money? Because if we are doing the gospel for money, we will do it anyhow. And if we are doing it for God, we will do it wholeheartedly. You know,
the problem here is this. There are a lot of people, we don't fear God. You understand? We don't fear God. That is our biggest problem, as Christians, or let me say as Muslims. We don't fear our religious destinations. We don't fear God. You understand? We don't fear God. Because we can say that, I can fornicate, but because you will not see the consequences today. You understand? God will not slumber you today or just kill you instantly as he does before. Because now we are living under grace, you understand? So it is up to you to think of it and repent yourself. So as I was saying, we don't fear God. That is the problem we have. If you fear God, or after doing something, you know that the punishment comes instantly, we'll do it right away. And now people are using the name of this God
to make money,
and then to brainwash people, and to make money. So if that is why it is good for everybody to know the word. If you know the word, nobody can come and deceive you.
With their songs,
with maybe their songs or anything. Let's say, for instance, that you know that this is called chair. Okay, you know that it's called headset. Then someone comes to tell you, this one is called umbrella. Will you accept it? You say no, it's not umbrella, it is headset. But if you don't know the name of this, someone come and tell the umbrella, say yeah, it's true, it's umbrella. You understand? So that is how the system is going.
So we shouldn't do the gospel for money, we should do it for God.
We should do it for God.
Okay. I have one more question for you.
Yeah.
Is it good for a pastor to listen to God's secular music?
Is it good for a pastor?
secular music.
Okay. You know, if you are a pastor, you are listening to secular music, as I said from the beginning, that music is life, and music can change you, the person. It's the same thing I say, for example, you are a pastor, you are watching pornographic movies. If you are watching porn, and let's say you are, even someone comes to you and to pray for you, if you are not careful, you end up doing something wrong. So if you are listening to a secular music, it will reach a point that, you know, because light and darkness cannot move together. If you are beside to listen to secular music, the Holy Spirit cannot descend. The Bible, you know, the Bible says that it says pray without ceasing. Always you must be attentive and sensitive in the spirit. So if you are listening to secular music, that the manifestation of the Holy Spirit cannot have total impact on you. It's like this is one world of secular music, this is another world of gospel music. So if you are in the gospel world and you are mixing yourself with this one, it means even you yourself, you don't know what you are doing. Yourself, you are confused. You are, the Bible call it, divided, what is this? Divided, you have a divided thoughts, you know. You don't know what exactly you are doing. So you must, we must focus on one thing, and when we concentrate on what we are doing, then you have good results. But if you are here small, you do this small, it means you don't know what you are doing. It means yourself, you are already confused. So it means you are yet going to confuse your followers.
So if you are a Christian and you start listening to a secular music, the advice to you is what my brother is saying. There are certain things these secular musicians, they do or they say in their songs that does not attract the Holy Spirit. And gradually you will also find yourself into it. Because let's say if you are watching a secular video, music video, there are some kind of pictures, kind of things that they show there. It does not collide with you know, with a Christian life. Yeah, so what my brother is trying to say, that she will mingle with the secular musician, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So we thank you so much for being with us. Secular musicians and gospel musicians. If you are a gospel musician, to my point of view, don't do collaboration with a secular musician. Because as you are doing a collaboration with a secular musician, it will, you know, it will take you from where you belong to the academy, because you are trying to make money. You are trying to make money, but God did not call you to do that thing for money. Okay, if you do the gospel and you get money, it's good. But trying to get money because of the gospel you are doing, that's not right. That's not right. The gospel, God gave us that anointing to minister to people so that it will change people's life. You understand? And for a pastor also to invite a secular musician into his house, first of all,
this church or himself.
Yeah, sorry, in this church. First of all, you have to think about the congregation. People who are following you. Because me, if I'm following you and I see you are a pastor who invites secular musicians into your the house of God, I will not follow you again, because I can see you are deviating, you know. There is a certain way for you to transform that secular musician, not by giving him the pulpit to worship, because as I said, he's not willing. So when he comes, the spirit which leads him is the spirit that he's coming to minister to your congregation, so they will get that spirit also, you see. So they shouldn't give them pulpit. If you want to change someone, then there are so many ways to change someone. You understand? Because the moment, okay, I quite remember one of kind of a secular musician, Kwame Eugene. He went to one church and he said, before I was a worshiper, but now no more, because certain things did not go well. He was not making money out of it. You understand? So it means now he can sing the worship song, but the spirit would, you know, transform you through that worship. Is not there. He will sing rather, but that spirit is no longer. You understand? So we shouldn't, you know, mix ourselves. We have to understand the word. We have to understand where we belong. And I hope you understand what I'm saying. Let us be in our lane. If we are increasing, let us be in our lane. If you want to be in this secular music also, let us join in this music industry. Because in Ghana, especially in my country, now I don't see any gospel songs anymore. I don't see gospel songs. Because the songs that they are doing as gospel, I count it as secular songs. Yeah, secular music. Because even sometimes when they are shooting a video, the kind of video, the things that they are doing in their video, only God knows. You know, we are not here to judge, but I'm here to, you know, share my views about secular music and gospel music. This is the music industry. So if you want to be on the right, if you want to be on the left, just be there. And God bless you today. My brother, what do you have to say
today?
Yeah,
all I have to tell my viewers is that, you know, music is life and music can change us. So if you are a Christian, if you are a Muslim, and we give ourselves up into secular industry, you know, our thoughts will change towards things. Yeah, our thoughts will change towards things. So let us be on our lane, and then God will make a good way for us. No, remember the Bible says that seek ye first the kingdom of heaven, and all other things will be added unto you. So it is us to seek Him, so that all other things will be added unto us. God bless all of you, and please don't forget to subscribe. This is Wise Multimedia. Click the red letter waist down, and then once after clicking, don't forget to hit the notification bell for all notifications, so that you can receive all our videos. And our Expo 2020 is still on the way. We will follow up, so kindly subscribe so that you can get every update as Expo is about to start. God bless all of you.
Okay, God bless you. And there are some people, when they are trying to subscribe, it comes sign in. Please, if it comes sign in, don't be scared. You know, just try and just sign in, because if you sign in, it will not be like they will deduct your credit. Although some of the GB will go, but it's not something that you have to fear about. You just sign in with your Google account. Then when you sign in with your Google account, that's when you can subscribe. If you don't sign in, you cannot subscribe. So first sign in, then you subscribe. God bless you. And we have one video, gospel video we'll talk about. So let us meet next time, talk about the video. Then you also can share your views. If this song is a gospel song or secular song, God bless you. And have a blessed day ahead. God bless you.
Bye-bye.